Hi, my name is Paige George, and I'm the Federal Laboratory Consortium Southeast Regional Coordinator. At the FLC, we are always looking for new ways to connect with the laboratories that make up our membership. As part of our campaign to educate, facilitate, and promote federal technology transfer, we want to provide more opportunities to take you behind the curtain of our labs to take a deep dive into some of the incredible technologies developed through the use of our technology transfer agreements. The first lab we are going to feature is a Department of Defense laboratory, the Naval Surface Warfare Center, Panama City Division, where I serve as the Technology Transfer Manager in our Office of Research and Technology Application. The mission of NSWC PCD began in the 1940s with mine countermeasures research during the World War II era. This mission has expanded to include research, development, test and evaluation, and in-service support in mine warfare, diving and life support systems, and amphibious and expeditionary warfare systems, as well as other missions in the littoral battle space, from seafloor to space and coastal regions. By 2020, the lab boasted over 1,500 employees, over 900 of which are scientists and engineers. NSWC PCD's unique location on the Gulf of Mexico in sunny Florida makes it the perfect operating location to support its littoral battle space mission. So sit back, relax, and enjoy a voyage to the world's most beautiful beaches, the home of military diving, the Naval Surface Warfare Center, Panama City Division.
Hi, I'm Dr. Cameron Matthews. I'm at Naval Surface Warfare Center, Panama City. I've been here since about 2006. I'm the Chief Scientist for Counter Unmanned Undersea Systems Technologies right now. So I first heard about Collaborative Research and Development Agreements, CRADAs, maybe 10 years ago. And I had someone come to me and say, we're not doing work in these areas. We have some partners. We want to see if we can work this out. And we started the process. And after a little while, I figured out that it's a really easy way to get access to ongoing cutting edge work. CRADAs best support research and development efforts when there is an issue of IP and a desire to share that in a way that both parties feel safe in the sharing. And CRADAs also benefit programs where industry does not have access to a technical capability that only the government can provide. Typically, when we start a program or if we're working with another contractor and a certain need arises where a CRADA fits that, meaning that partner has some form of IP that they're not comfortable sharing directly. We've managed to transfer unmanned undersea vehicle technologies to CRADA partners in academia and industry. We've also managed to develop some new methods for implementing sensors and sensor technologies into our systems. We're in the process of developing some CRADAs to actually release our government-furnished autonomy and make our vehicles completely open architecture, open source for all end users. A really good example is a current CRADA we have going on, and we needed to start transferring our fully developed government autonomy package from the man portable and medium class expendable vehicles we do into large diameter UUV systems. So we wanted to start manufacturing expendable LD UUVs, and C4 has a platform that is essentially ready for acceptance of that autonomy, so we entered into a CRADA with them. And the benefit was immediate. So we now have access to a developmental, expendable, large diameter UUV asset via the CRADA approach, while C4 is getting full access to the fully developed government-furnished autonomy capability.
Hi, I'm Allie Williams. I'm currently a project manager for information displays in the diving community. I've been here for about 6 years. I first heard about CRADAs from my previous project manager, who was in charge of the DAVID system, the Diver's Augmented Vision Display. And he had been involved with them in the past and kind of introduced the concept to us and thought this would be a good project for a CRADA. And so we kind of started from there. We decided to enter into a CRADA based on a few years ago, we started out with a tasking to develop heads-up display and a dive helmet. And so we did the research, we had a first prototype, and we kind of got to that point where we wanted to transition it to a manufactured unit and we wanted to learn from the industry. And so we entered into a CRADA to collaborate with Coda Octopus, who's our CRADA partner, and get the system fielded, get it manufactured, and kind of move on from our research and prototyping phase. Our industry partner is Coda Octopus, and in the beginning, when we were looking at CRADAs and who would be our partner, they had a lot of expertise in sonar and underwater sonar, 3D scans, live feeds, and that's something we hadn't really approached yet with our system. We were more focused on the HUD development, the heads-up display development. And so it was a good combination of them adding in their capability of sonar and adding in our HUD, and then the divers now can see like live real-time 3D sonar right in their helmet. So under this CRADA, we have worked really closely with Coda Octopus. In the very beginning, we signed the CRADA in about 2017. I traveled over there to their headquarters and sat down with their engineers and, you know, handed over our technical data package, handed over all our drawings and our concepts, and worked with them on our prototyping and kind of started from there. And then they added in their expertise and transferred it to manufactured design and brought in like the sonar, like I said. And we just kind of, the engineers worked really closely, project management worked really closely. So normally at the Navy lab here in Panama City, we focus on the research and development. And when we partner with the CRADA, we're able to stay focused on the research and development because they transition it to a manufactured unit, they get it to the fleet, and we can focus on the next thing the Navy needs and stay more in the like developmental phases while they're helping to field the unit. Resulting from the CRADA, we were able to produce a manufactured unit. The Navy has purchased some of these. There's still ongoing development that we're involved in on future capabilities or upgrades to the system. So we're still working really closely with Coda and giving a lot of feedback, a lot of technical advice or expertise from the Navy side. And we're still collaborating and working on Gen 2 David, Gen 3 David, and future capabilities. But the system is currently fielded to different Navy dive commands. The advantages of using a CRADA versus a traditional method of like contracting out a product is a lot more collaborative. It's a lot more of the engineers working together day to day instead of just handing over a set of instructions or build instructions, something like that. So we've been involved in every step of the way, both on test sites, both providing feedback, technical feedback. Both partners in a CRADA benefit from the project as far as like on our design side, we get a lot of manufacturing expertise and we learn more about industry practice and how to design for that better from the beginning. And then the industry partner learns a lot about our research and the Navy's needs and kind of how we get our data and what our needs are. So I think both sides benefit from a CRADA, so I definitely plan to pursue these in the future. Another great outcome of a CRADA is that we received a patent on our David system and we can now license that to our CRADA partners or industry partners, and that really benefits the inventors, the engineers, and the Navy.
On behalf of the Federal Laboratory Consortium and the Naval Surface Warfare Center, Panama City Division, thank you for watching.